Okay, so Jeff starts this song with the band up in the key of C minor, and it's a very funky song, and there are actually two intros, which the licks are actually more or less the same. They're slightly different, but I'll play them the same. And it's a quick succession of notes with pull-offs, very cool, and ends on a G minor suspended chord. So let's have a look at how he plays the intro. Once more. Okay, so what he does is he actually pulls off the notes. So he does this interesting move. So he stays in the box in the eighth position, but he has the pinky on the 11th fret of the low E note. So he does, and note the palm mute there. So once more. And he ends on this G minor chord with an additional C on a G string. It's probably accidental, but I like it anyway, so I kept it. It's like a G minor suspended. So he does it once more. But he ends differently. He does, so he pulls on the A string to get ready for the funky part in C. Okay, so then comes the funky part in C, which is like a C7, C9. He doesn't play the low C note. And he basically follows the keyboard, so he does a... He does it a few times. He does a variation. He does something like this. Like eighth position with your pinky here, like a seven, and he turns it into a six. It's only once, so it's very fast. He does that a bit more until he goes to the first break, the first solo. So then he slides into the first note. So he does this like this, and he bends it straight away. Very cool. So let's do that bend once more. Do it as well as Jeff, of course, but and he does this big bend, and he keeps keeps it sustaining when he comes back to the original notes. Taps on. So he does this type of stuff a lot, where it's sort of like a unison bend where you wouldn't expect it. So then minor third. Something like that. So from that part here with the big bend, he basically comes back and does something cool. So it's like a backward bend, a pre-bend. He does a double stop and bends that too. And then comes an interesting part. So I've never heard anybody play this. It's probably improvised, but it's so darn good. So he does this, like he's on the F and the major F. Jeff slides into the 17th position for the major solo, and I find this actually very tough to play, but I'll try what I can find. He does a few notes which I haven't been able to decipher yet, but let's see where we end up. This a lot, and he does a very big bend, basically the highest you can go. So here, but he does it from the 17th position, so he basically stretches his pinky. And then he goes down again. Bends with his first, with his index finger. Once more. Okay, and the next section is this. Find it easier to slide in like this. And he goes to the neck position. And he does this sort of cool bend in between. Something like that. Thank you. funky. It's all about funk. So it ends on the C, and then there's a bass solo by Stephen Amazing, which is freaking amazing. And the solo is in D. I'm not going to play the bass solo. But after the bass solo, there's a section in C minor again. So we turn off the color sound power boost, and he basically starts here. So again, this pre-bend. Pull off to the open string. He ends on this quarter note bend. And he does another pull off. So like three notes in a row. Another index finger bend. This is also with an index finger, I think. Moves up to 8th position. He does a sort of different notes in his bend, right? So he does... This is what it should be. Open strings here. Okay, then again some open notes and some pull-offs. So this is reminiscent of what he did in his early days with the Yardbirds, like this. But he does it here in the open C. And unfortunately, I can't really decipher what he's doing, but it sounds something like this. So he does sort of a pull off from the C. Once more. If you know how to do it, let me know. I'm interested. And then that's the end of the solo part. So he goes back to the rhythm. So he still has it still in the bridge position, and he has some volume left. So he does this. It sort of slides into a C sharp 9 or whatever it is. And then he makes a, you know, like the Hendrix chord, a 7 flat 9 or whatever it is. So it's... Sounds very cool. And then from there he does his volume goes up. So he turns up the knob. Follows the keyboard again, and he does so. The keyboard player does this thing where he bends a note with the little thumb wheel. So he does something similar. He does. So tune. Should be something like this. He doesn't do it all the time, but he does it a few times. But he goes on. So the ending is interesting. It's basically, if you look at the chords, he's playing like they're the bass chords, basically. So he starts with E flat, and then it moves to D, it moves to C sharp, and it ends with C. And he basically plays the melody in that key every time. So he plays something in E sharp or E flat, then he plays something in D, then he plays something in C sharp, and he ends in the C minor scale. So it goes something like this. Let's do that again. Decipher. Then to C sharp. Exactly sure what he does there. If you do know, let me know. But it's sort of complicated. He does it very quickly. And he ends on C. So once more slow. So that's a very cool ending, and it's quite complicated. He is obviously flair of the moment, you know, very improvised, and I love Jeff to death, but this is something which is so hard to replicate. If you know how to do it, please let me know. But this is sort of what I came up with, and hope you liked it, and all the best.